two main arguments for the use of 3D printing. I would say this is the customization at no extra cost, but also then that we can create complex geometries that are not possible before. My name is Benjamin Dillenburger. I'm professor for digital building technologies at the ETH Zurich. So I'm an architect, and I'm researching how one can use the computer to design new kinds of architecture, unimaginable architecture, and then also finding the right appropriate tools or strategies how to fabricate those with robots. Our project uses 3D printing in combination with concrete works, but we are not directly 3D printing the concrete, we are printing the foam work. This means that we basically can take the advantage of 3D printing. Complex geometry is not an issue anymore. Bespoke geometry is not an issue anymore. But we can combine it with the traditionally very strong structural capacities of concrete. The idea is that we design a slab structure which does not require so much material. And that's very relevant because usually in building, slabs are the part of the structure which take most of the material compared to the columns and so on. So sometimes over 80% of the entire structure are slabs. So if we want and we have to save material in these structures, we need to start to differentiate and optimize the forms. And we are trying to tackle this challenge by using 3D printing to make it cheaper and possible at all to save material and only use concrete where needed. The productivity in building industry has to change. We are facing challenges in future. I think some reports say in the next 50 years, we will build more houses than we built so far as mankind. And if we want to do this in a sustainable way, we need to find new ways of building. This makes totally sense to scale up to, for example, a high-rise building, because every optimized slab would add on in terms of efficiency. We could maybe save the floor height and then gain a couple of floors for an entire high-rise building. So there's a huge potential, and we believe that technologies like robotic fabrication and 3D printing is very well suited to enter this market, because in architecture, in the best case, we anyway don't want to standardize each building. Like, architecture is much stronger, much better, and better performing if you have really customized solutions for the specific context. And here then digital fabrication comes into play.